everyone to another edition of Play It Through, and on this edition it's Gunsmoke, brought to us by Capcom. Based on the arcade game of the same name, but not having anything to do with the classic Western television show, Gunsmoke did feature less levels on the NES, but it was still a great port with some great music that was actually different from the arcade version, and some of my favorite action gameplay available on the NES. We play as the cowboy bounty hunter known as Billy Bob, as he travels from area to area taking out a new bounty, eventually leading to his final showdown with the Wingate Gang. So here we go with Gunsmoke for the NES. After you start up the game, just stay at the title menu for just a few seconds, and then you'll get the story for the game. With that complete, it's now time to press start and go into the game. The first level of the game is the town of Hicksville, and the first person we're going to be taking out is Bandit Bill. Gunsmoke is a great vertical scrolling shooter. You have two methods of fire, firing to the left and firing to the right depending upon which button you press, and then you can press both together in order to actually fire straight. The controls are obviously rather simple, and your main goal is going to be dodging all the enemies spread out throughout the level, as well as all their weaponry, whether it's dynamite, or bullets, or a combination of both. And being one of those vertical scrolling shooters back in the day, this is an extremely tough game because you also have to deal with the fact that one hit equals a death. There is a way to get a few more hits by picking up the horse upgrade, but we'll talk about that in a little bit. The goal in each of the levels is not only just to get through the level by defeating the enemies, it's actually to find a wanted poster that you must pick up in order to actually activate the boss battle. If you don't pick up the wanted poster, the boss will not spawn, and you'll actually have to re-loop the stage until you're able to find it. These wanted posters are hidden, so you'll have to know the locations of them and try to find them in order to actually complete the stages. And what would any vertical scrolling shooter be without power-ups? And this game definitely has a few. Of course, you have your basic ones that are going to give you more speed. Those are represented by a pair of boots on the ground. If you pick up a rifle that's laying on the ground, that increases the length of your fire, how far your bullets will actually travel. You have a POW block that when you pick it up off the ground will actually destroy all the enemies currently on screen. You can also buy things from the shop using money and points that you end up picking up along the way. These extra weapons that you can get will definitely help you out in certain situations, such as the shotgun, or the magnum, or even the machine gun. I actually will spend some time in the first level alone building up some money and actually purchasing some of these gun upgrades. Also located in the game is two of Capcom's famous items, the Yashashi, which has made appearances in lots of different Capcom games, including the Mega Man series. This little pinwheel-like shuriken item that you pick up, there's actually two different versions in this game. A red one, which gives you an extra life, and a blue one, which will grant you brief invincibility. But, of course, the best power-up that you've seen so far, and I've already been using for a good amount of the level, is the horse. The horse gives you great movement overall, and it also allows you to take multiple hits. The horse actually can take 3 to 4 hits before it ends up dropping, so this gives you multiple hits to take, especially during really tough areas of the game, and can definitely help you out. In this first level, and we've been seeing them throughout this thing, there's really only two basic enemies. The green guys, who have a singular bullet that comes out, and they can be a pain only when they get in bunches, but trust me, if you can't handle these guys, we're gonna have some trouble as we get later in the game, because you end up having a ton of enemies and bullets on screen at once. You also have the dynamite guys. These guys, of course, throw dynamite at you, and you'll have to do your best to avoid the little explosions that happen when you get them. I'm stopping by the shop here and buying the most expensive gun in the game, the Magnum. The Magnum can hold a total of 100 bullets if you get all the ammo for it, and is easily the most powerful of the guns in the game. Since you're able to actually keep the guns in your inventory and carry them over to another level once you've completed that stage, I spend time usually getting the Magnum in this first level. However, that's by no means foolproof because, of course, if you have a gun equipped, you can end up losing it if you lose a life with that gun equipped. That's the only way you're able to lose one of the guns in your equipment other than, of course, game over. The guys with the shotguns are the toughest enemies in this area of the game because they have a 3-shot spread shot and they take a lot of hits to take out before you're able to drop them. But with the upgraded ammo clips that we have that allow us for lengthening shots, we're able to take out the shotgun enemies from a big distance. We're now going to be actually getting the wanted poster, and there's two ways you can get the wanted poster. There's a wanted poster hidden in every one of the levels. To find it, you have to shoot at a specific spot multiple times in order to actually locate it. The other and more simpler way to do it is actually by just talking to the redheaded beard guy that we've seen a couple of times, go to his shop, and you're able to actually purchase the wanted poster. Since where I'm at in the game currently, it's just going to be best just to wait for that shop guy anyway, so I'm going to wait till I get to him and then buy the wanted poster from that guy. While making it back to the shopkeeper or getting back to the point where the wanted poster is, try to do your best and try to keep the horse as long as possible. After this long open area between the buildings, we come to this guy and we can go to his shop and you can actually buy a horse, you can buy extra ammo, and of course we can buy the wanted poster, so that's what we'll be picking up here. Here is the location of one of the blue Yashashis, which as you can see causes me to flash a little bit, and that means I have brief invincibility. Anything that hits me will not harm me during that time. Unfortunately though, it doesn't last too long. I do end up spending a pretty good amount of time in the first level alone, but it ends up being my benefit, I think, in the end. Once you make it up here and the screen stops scrolling, you have to take out a bunch of enemies before the bandit will make his appearance. He shoots straight forward with a machine gun, so try to stay near the bottom of the screen, dodging in and out of his machine gun fire and keep firing. You actually can get him stuck in the left or right corners here, and keep firing as he hangs out near the bottom of the screen as far as he can go, and you can keep landing in shots. As long as you're making contact with him, you are doing damage, but it takes a lot of hits to actually drain a piece of his health. Once he's taken care of though, we move on to level 2. The second level is a little bit more complicated because you have smaller spaces to deal with. The rock formations on the left and right sides that you actually have to maneuver and weave around can actually allow for enemies to be on top of them and jump down and shoot you from above. I switch over to the Magnum for a little bit. I can use this and actually pick up some more ammo along the way to keep my total amount of ammo for it up for the most part. As you can see, it clears out enemies really well and will definitely help you out in any area of the game. It doesn't matter where you are. The enemies for the most part are the same in this level as they were in the first, except they add this machine gun like firing guy. He comes down a little bit from the screen and then stops and then fires in all kinds of different directions real quick. Thankfully, in some of these areas, because of all the stuff going on with the cactuses and the rock formations, it ends up being your benefit and you actually avoid most of the shots. I'm stopping by this shop right here and picking up another one of the wanted posters, so once we get to the point where he is, we'll be able to take out the second level boss. Since we have the wanted poster already in our possession, we just have to do our best to avoid all the fire. Hanging out near the bottom of the screen is always beneficial, only coming up when you need to in order to grab some extra items, as well as you can also do this to get some enemies stuck on the right side of the screen, especially if there's objects in the center. Just like before, we'll eventually get to the point where the screen will stop and it's time to get ready for the boss. This guy will come down by slowly jumping down, and he'll actually come all the way near the bottom of the screen, eventually stopping to throw out two boomerangs. These boomerangs can be a little bit annoying to avoid, but if you stand in the right positions, you'll be able to avoid both of them by having them just go directly past you. Just be careful because they do retract and you'll have to step out of the way when they come back towards them. However, with the Magnum equipped, we take him out easily and we move on to stage number 3. Level 3, as we're trying to take out Devil Hawk, starts to begin the harder part of the game. You have a lot more enemies on screen at once for you to deal with, and you have all new types of enemies to deal with as well. You have these big guys that'll jump around that take multiple hits in order to take out. You have your normal gun guys, but these guys move a lot quicker than the gun guys from the previous level. They can also come up from behind you, which can get extremely annoying and catch you off guard, so you have to hang out a little bit above the actual bottom of the screen. You also then have the knife-throwing enemies. These guys in the blue pants will move back and forth in a circular-like pattern, and then launch knives straight at you, and they move rather quickly, so try to do your best to step out of their direct fire range. Last but not least, you also have the tomahawk throwing guys. These guys aren't as fast, but they throw out multiple tomahawks. This is where knowing the location, especially of the Yashishi, which can give you some brief invincibility, can definitely help out, as well as having the money and the ability to buy some of the upgrades for your guns. Having the shotgun, magnum, or even machine gun during this stage can definitely help you survive a little bit longer. Any opportunity you may get in order to pick up a POW block, you definitely have to take the advantage to wipe out all the enemies currently on the screen. Unfortunately, we don't quite have enough here to actually buy the wanted poster from her, so we're just gonna wait and keep defeating some enemies and build up some of that money count. I will mention the location of the wanted poster you can get in the level itself. It's actually located above the next shopkeeper we're going to be coming to. But I probably will just loop around instead and continue on defeating a lot of the enemies for some extra money here in case I need it later on in the game to buy a horse or something in a later stage. Now here's the shopkeeper I mentioned. Above him is a lone rock on the next patch of grass. If you end up shooting at that area a few times, you may be able to find the hidden warden poster, but sometimes I always had trouble getting some of these to appear. That singular rock and that barrel in between there, that's where the warden poster can appear if you fire multiple times. Thankfully, it won't take us too long to loop back around, and you'll be able to see more enemy dodging and more enemy firing as we make our way through the stage as we get back to the end. Be sure to pick up the red Yashishi here so you can get yourself an extra life. While this game is actually a port of an arcade game, it's actually interesting to see just how many differences there are between the arcade version and the NES version. I always grew up playing this version and never got a chance to play the arcade version until a few years ago, and I was actually pretty surprised, besides obviously of course graphical differences, the fact that the soundtracks were actually vastly different from the arcade to the NES version, as well as there's actually 10 levels in the arcade version, while there's only 6 levels in the NES version of the game. Also, the arcade version of the game didn't have multiple guns like the NES version did. It didn't have the shotgun, machine gun, magnum, or even the smart bomb. And not only were there less levels and less bosses, they actually ended up changing the names of the arcade bosses when it came over to the NES. Also, instead of the Wingate Gang, it was actually the Wingate Family, being two sons and a father, where they made it into an actual gang of members in this version of the game. Since there wasn't extra guns in the game, you didn't have a shop for you to actually buy those weaponry, and also the Yashishi, the blue one, wasn't in the arcade version, though the red one did make an appearance. Heck, there was actually even some minor changes between the NES version of the game and the Famicom Disk System version of the game that was released, of course, in Japan. Besides, of course, the NES version of the game, there actually was a few other versions of the game, mainly released for PCs. They released a version for the MXX, the IBM PC, and the ZX Spectrum, and one that I found most interesting, and one version I've never played, is for the Amstrad CPC. The game was changed to the name Desperado, and also, they ended up getting a sequel for the game called Desperado 2. Now, I haven't really looked up any information on that one, but I do find it interesting that any type of sequel for the game was made. Now, when we get back to the shopkeeper, of course, we're going to be purchasing the wanted poster this time around, and now we just have to get back to the end so we can actually finally complete the level this time. I always find it that once I'm able to actually get the horse ability, I end up having a much easier time overall. I think it's because you get a little bit more relaxed because you don't have to worry about a one-hit death, so it's definitely a little bit less tension. Another good thing that I was able to do by going through the level one more time was I was able to build up some extra money. I can now use this money in the later levels to help me have a little bit of an advantage as far as being able to get the wanted poster from the shop earlier if I want to. I also have the money in order to buy an extra gun if I do need it as well, especially in case I accidentally do lose a life at some point during the game. One thing that's always key as far as actually using the special guns in the game is to make sure that you actually pick up any little ammo drops that drop down so you can keep your total ammo for that gun up as high as possible, especially if you're able to afford the Magnum. Once again, when we get to the top, the screen will stop scrolling, and we'll have to take out a few enemies at the bottom here before Firehawk ends up appearing. And this guy's the toughest boss yet. His spread shot can reach pretty far. The good thing is, if you're able to stay far away from him, what you can do is, as soon as he fires, back away real quick to the left side, and you'll avoid all his fire while still being able to get in some shots with the Magnum. The Magnum, just like before, will drain his health rather quickly, and once he's able to be defeated, we move on to level 4. Level 4 takes place on Death Mountain, and no, we won't be actually finding any Gorons or anything located on Death Mountain. Instead, we're going to be actually taking out ninjas, because our opponent for this level is, well, he's named Ninja. Now, a lot of the enemies in this level are going to be the normal enemies we've already been taking out, but there is ninja-based enemies, as well as you also have enemies that are located in the mountains themselves, consistently firing from the holes in the mountain. I'm going to stop by here and buy the shotgun. Now, I will use the shotgun in a little bit to show it off as it gives you a nice little spread shot, but of course since it's the least expensive of the extra guns in the game, it's really not the most powerful. The ninja enemies, though, are relatively fast and they can throw shurikens, so be sure not to be standing directly in front of one while taking one out, so his shuriken that he throws out won't hit you. Of course, these ninjas are also a pain because they can actually charge at you with their sword drawn, so if you see them stop near you and they start charging, be sure to mash the fire button really quickly to hit them before they're actually able to make contact with you. Thankfully, we can stop by this shop right here and we can buy ourselves the wanted poster. This is a pretty tough level overall, and it's not one I recommend staying in too long to build any of your money up. At some point, like when you get here, you'll have some enemies coming at you from below, so you'll really have to float in the middle of the screen, and when you have enemies above and below you firing at you consistently, it can get rather tricky. Now, I did show off the shotgun a little bit. As you can see, it has a nice spread shot, but the bullets don't go out very far, so it's really not that effective unless you're in a very small cluster of enemies. And when you have enemies coming up from behind you, you gotta be really careful with your shots. If you're able to find it, or if you're able to buy it, I do recommend getting the horse in this stage, especially if you have to travel through the stage more than one time. This is definitely the toughest level we've had to deal with so far, and there's just so many bullets and enemies on screen at once. The worst part is when you get to an area like this, in a very small area, with enemies in front and behind, as well as the rocks rolling down the mountain. Of course, once the screen stops scrolling, it's time to get ready for the boss battle. You have some purple enemies that will appear, and you'll have to take them out. And eventually, you'll see the boss, the ninja, teleport in. Now, this is the toughest boss we've had to deal with so far, because you have to be prepared for when he appears to be able to get a shot in on him. Thankfully, though, he really isn't too difficult to deal with, because if you hit him quickly, he won't fire any projectiles out. But he does have a ton of little minions with him as well. Once you're able to knock him down though, you defeat him, we can move on to level 5. Next up, level 5, and we have our boss, Fat Man Joe. Right near the beginning of the level, you actually have a shop, so you can pick up any other gun you need, which I will be picking up the machine gun here. That way I now will showcase all the guns in the game. As you can see, for the most part, the level doesn't have really any new enemies, but the tougher enemies that fire out multiple shots are a mainstay in this level. There's also large amounts of water you'll have to cross over, as well as bridges. The good thing is though, you can actually go through the water itself, so you don't have to worry about being just on the bridge. Of course, being said though, the enemies also travel in the water. In my opinion though, this level isn't nearly as tough as the previous stage, so you shouldn't have too much trouble with this one if you were able to get through the last stage pretty easily. But you do still have enemies from below, so you'll have to be careful and still hang out a little bit above the bottom of the screen, near the middle of the screen. Here's the machine gun, and as you can see, it fires a ton of bullets out really, really quickly. They aren't powerful, but they are about as powerful as the normal shot in the game, so that really ends up coming in handy. This female shopkeeper right up here is the one who keeps the wanted poster, so we'll be purchasing that. So now we have the wanted poster, so all we need to do is get through the level and complete the stage by defeating the boss. I find actually following along the path works pretty well as far as taking out a lot of the normal enemies. As well as, of course, when you get to big lakes of water, if you can shoot a barrel and find one of the hidden pals, be sure to hit it and take them all out, even though the ones are hidden underneath the water itself. Once you get past that big lake, the area completely opens up. There really isn't even any trees in this area. Just be careful of all the dynamiters throwing the dynamite, of course, and then once you take out all the enemies, be prepared, because you'll have to take out these few weird gray suit enemies before Fat Joe shows up. Now, he's quite large and bounces all around. He uses a giant bazooka weapon that when it lands, his bullets will actually explode, causing a little explosion effect, so not only can you not get hit by the bullet, but you also of course need to avoid the explosion. The good thing is though, pull out that magnum and you can drain his health really easily. Since he doesn't have the greatest movement, I still find him a pretty easy overall boss, even easier than the ninja boss. With level 5 complete, it's now time to move on to level 6, and this is Wingate Fortress, and of course we're taking out the Wingate Gang, the final level of the game. Being the final level of the game, there is a ton of enemies on screen. You have all basic enemies from the other levels will be making an appearance here throughout this stage, so you'll have to be careful as far as avoiding all the different types of fire. Here I'm going to end up buying myself one of the smart bombs, because it's the only weapon I think I haven't shown throughout the game. If you become proficient at dodging most of the normal enemies, as far as the shotgun enemies, the normal bullet guys, even the knife guys, you shouldn't have too much trouble being able to avoid most of the projectile fire here. You also want to use up any of your extra ammo you have, except if you want to hold on to that magnum. Now the smart bomb, as expected, pretty much works like the POW. You can use it and it destroys all enemies currently on screen, which can be very helpful, especially during this level when you get a ton of enemies on screen at once. There's a lot of little gravestones set up throughout the areas as well. These can be a little bit of a pain to maneuver around, so try to be careful. Stop by this shop up here and be sure to grab yourself the wanted poster. Unfortunately, it does not leave me enough money here though to buy the horse, but I should be okay. However, I recommend if you do of course have it, be sure to buy that horse. Since we're so close to actually completing the game, we're going to do our absolute best not to get hit by any of the enemies, especially if we're holding one of the guns that we need. Having the magnum for the final boss battle will definitely come in handy, so be sure to have some ammo for it if possible. This is the last set of buildings and all in the stage before we get to the open area for the boss battle, so just be careful you don't get kind of stuck or cornered on any of the objects in here, especially with all the little green guys running around. Thankfully, past that last building, the area with the buildings is now over, so you just have to maneuver around the last little bit of path, taking out the last few enemies before you actually get to where the screen will stop, and it's time to get ready for the actual boss fight. Once the screen stops, just like always, it's time to get ready for the boss. Take out some normal enemies first, and then the first boss will appear. He moves around rather quickly and has machine gun-like fire. Staying near the bottom of the screen will definitely be your best bet to easily maneuver and avoid the machine gun fire at all costs. Keep firing at him with the magnum gun and you'll be able to drain a lot of his health. However, once he's taken care of, that's not it. You actually have another guy to deal with. But first, you must take out a couple of normal enemies, and then he'll appear. This fight is just like the first one, so just be very careful, stay at the bottom of the screen, and use the rest of your magnum ammo that you have. Once your magnum ammo runs out, switch to something like the shotgun or the machine gun to help you out to continue draining this guy's health. Of course, without the magnum, it will take a lot more bullets to drain a piece of his health, but as long as you keep your distance, you should be able to still do damage to him and avoid his fire. Once you deliver the final hit though, you can sit back and enjoy the ending to Gunsmoke for the NES. So after a nice little ending, we now of course come to our credits. Gunsmoke is easily one of my favorite arcade shooters available for the NES. Capcom does a fantastic job with this game overall, and I can't recommend it enough. After completing the game though, you can press start and you actually can start the game all over again, and just like an arcade, you can keep going and going. However, with that, that's going to wrap up this edition of Play It Through. I'd like to thank you for watching, and of course, I hope you enjoyed.